Each day, commuters in Metro Atlanta travel through a complex maze of lanes, ramps, and interchanges. As one of the fastest growing cities in the Southeast, Atlanta roadways are a vital part of the region's economy. The task of keeping all that traffic flowing falls to the Georgia Department of Transportation. Bryant Poole is GDOT's District 7 engineer.
Every day we have over 25 million daily miles traveled in the Metro Atlanta area. Now that's equivalent to being responsible for over 1,000 centerline miles that we have to take care of.
GDOT's District 7 is comprised of 6 counties in the Metro Atlanta area. With the highest traffic density in Georgia, any interruption caused by road construction and repairs can result in long delays and traveler frustration.
Well, we understand the concept of get in and get out, and in doing so, that is very important in the pavement structures that we utilize and design for today. Obviously, you want to design for pavement structures that will give you long-term life and the greatest benefit cost to that pavement. Concrete meets that challenge today more so than ever. The object is to get in and get out and stay out of the traveling public, which minimizes the effect to them.
In the last 10 years, the Georgia Department of Transportation stepped up efforts to increase traffic capacity and enhance highway safety. GDOT pavement designers often turn to concrete to provide a safe, rigid surface that stands up to the demands of heavy traffic while providing long life and low maintenance. This major project on Interstate 85 features continuously reinforced concrete pavement, a type of road surface that combines concrete with steel rebars throughout its length.
In the section of I-85, it's very unique that what we're doing is widening that section with new concrete pavement, and in doing so, we're also rehabilitating the existing pavement and putting in the continuous reinforced mat in that section, again, to give us the long-term life of that pavement.
Continuously reinforced concrete is also utilized on many of Georgia's secondary routes, such as Highway 6, a major artery for long-haul truck traffic.
We've utilized that on our secondary routes, on heavy truck volume routes, where the truck traffic is greater than 15%. Having steel in concrete gives us that ability to add strength as well as long-term. It gives you that long-term life.
Continuously reinforced concrete has been used in the United States since 1921 and was heavily used during construction of the original interstate system during the 1960s. Many of these roadways are still in use today, well beyond their projected life expectancy.
We have structures out there, specifically in concrete pavement today, being utilized on our interstate system that are 30 plus years old.
Many of Metro Atlanta's interchanges feature on-ramps, bridges, and exits constructed of concrete. It's been the preferred paving material for many of Georgia's interchanges because of its rigidity, low maintenance, long life, and ability to stay smooth over long periods of time.
Concrete pavement is ideal for heavy traffic volumes and heavy loadings that pavement will encounter over the life of it. Anytime trucks have to stop or vehicles are in a stopping mode, especially at the tops of ramps or whatever, that has a tremendous impact to the pavement, such as shoving and rutting and so forth. Concrete pavement minimizes that.
Poole served for many years as maintenance engineer for the entire state of Georgia. He saw firsthand the benefits concrete bring to road departments struggling to maintain a complex system of highways and secondary routes.
Once it's placed, it requires less maintenance. However, with that, it does require pavement preservation, which is minimal in comparison to flexible pavements.
Poole says GDOT has an effective pavement preservation program in place, again, to help minimize traffic interruptions due to construction.
Staying out of the traveler's way, as well as the safety. Having to get out and impact the traveling public is very important. And using concrete pavement enables us to, again, to stay out, to stretch the dollar as long as possible.
For the road to success, I'm Doug Barron.